So finally, the NVIDIA RTX 4070 Super is out there and we have third-party benchmarks from reputable sources. So the whole day I was looking at all the benchmarks published by big guns like Gamers Nexus and other big YouTubers. And my goal was to see if this card actually is worth your money. So we already know that this card is going for $600 and the RTX 4070 will get a $50 discount. Say for example, this Zotac card is going for $535. So the question is, should you consider RTX 4070 Super? Let's talk about it. This video is brought to you by scdkey.com, where you can purchase Windows 10 Pro OEM keys for only $15.77. Use the link in the video description below to purchase Windows 10 Pro or Windows 10 Home OEM keys, and don't forget to use my 25% coupon code TP25. To activate your Windows license, press and hold Windows key plus S and type activation settings in the search box. Next, click on Change Product Key at the bottom of the page and paste your newly purchased Windows 10 Pro OEM key. Wait for a few minutes and boom! Your Windows 10 Pro is now fully activated. And by the way, you can always upgrade to Windows 11 Pro for free. You can also get Microsoft Office 2019 and various other PC games. So check the links that I've put in the video description below. And now let's get back to the video. So here are all the 4070 Super benchmarks. Gamers Nexus is my favorite, but JZ, 2sense, Hardware Unbox, everybody did their benchmark and I have spent a whole bunch of time watching these videos. So here is the 1440p rasterization benchmark. This is the average of 9 games. Now the reason I am starting with 1440p resolution is because the RTX 4070 Super, this card is really not meant for 4K gaming, and if you plan to do 1080p gaming, you know, you don't really need to go to an RTX 4070 Super. You can save some money and get a cheaper card. But if you plan to do 1440p gaming, then I think this card is the sweet spot. RTX 4070 Super will get 113 FPS. This is the 9 game rasterization FPS, and if you compare it with RTX 4070, you are getting a significant bump. It's going from 98.2 to 113, and in fact it's very close to RTX 4070 Ti. That is actually a pretty good value for money in my opinion, because you are $200 cheaper and you are very close to RTX 4070 Ti level performance. So this is a good start. Now let's look at ray tracing performance. So this is the 6 game average, again 1440p resolution. So RTX 4070 Super is here, 61.8, way ahead of RTX 4070, 52.9. So that's a pretty good bump here. 4070 Ti is still quite far ahead. So for $600 price point, even if you don't care about artificial frames, you know, the frame generation, if you don't care about ray tracing, even then I think this is a good card. But there is one problem with this card, and that's the 12 gigabyte of video RAM. So let's take a look at the specs here. This is the 4070 Super and this is the 4070 Vanilla Edition. And as you can see, both these cards are still 192-bit memory bus and both these cards are still 12 gigabyte of GDDR6X. So this is the biggest problem with this card. If you are playing games where you are enabling high quality textures, which is going to suck up a lot of video RAM, then you will have a bottleneck, because 12 gigabyte of video RAM in the year 2024, especially when you are spending $600 on a card, I think that's a problem. So that is something that you will have to keep in mind. I would say that for the time being, it's looking fine. I know that there are few gaming titles which kind of suck because they are not optimized and so they need a lot more video RAM. But as we look into the future, I think this will become a bigger problem. So this is something that is definitely going to come back and bite you in the ass, and you should really think about it. Spending $600 on a card which has only 12 gig of video RAM, is that something that you are comfortable with? And if this is something that bothers you, then let's take a look at some of the other options that you have. So we are looking at RX 7800 XT, and you can get an RX 7800 XT for under $500. Now this card comes with 16 gigabyte of GDDR6 video RAM, and this is on a 256-bit memory bus. So this makes much more sense. 16 gigabyte of video RAM in 2024, that sounds reasonable to me. And especially when you are only paying $500 for this card, that is definitely a good thing. So here is RX 7800 XT, and it's behind 4070 70 Super. This is the rasterization performance. Of course, this is $500 and this is $600. So you will save $100 if you go with AMD card, but your rasterization performance will be below RTX 4070 Super. Now, if you don't care about ray tracing and if you don't care about video editing performance, then you could go either way. If you really want to save money, nothing wrong with RX 7800 XT. But if you do care about those things, if you care about AI, if you want to do some local text to image generation, you want to run Stable Diffusion, or if you're doing some AI related work locally on your PC, then Nvidia is your only choice, because both Intel and AMD are going to suck when it comes to AI workload. So as you can see here, you have around 21% increment in the CUDA cores in RTX 4070 Super. This is actually a pretty good improvement. Nvidia has actually given us a lot of CUDA cores. So definitely if you are doing AI workloads, or if you are into video editing or doing any kind of 3D animation, RTX 4070 Super is now a decent card. The bottleneck still is the memory. I would have really loved to see this card come out with 16GB of video RAM. Now, AMD fanboys will say that, hey, well, what about RX 7900 XT? RX 7900 XT is going for around $700, little over $700. This card has 20GB of video RAM, so that's actually more than RTX 4080 Super. So if you look at the performance of RX 7900 XT and if you compare it with RTX 4070 Super, in pure rasterization, it is actually ahead, 126 versus 113 FPS. The problem is when it comes to ray tracing, because in ray tracing, 7900 XT falls behind. So it's behind 4070 Super and it's barely above RTX 4070. This is almost a $500 card and this is a $600 card. And the AMD option, which is $700, at least $700, some of the cards are more than $700, it's still behind RTX 4070 Super. Now let's talk about video editing. So if you look at the Puget Bench score for Adobe Premiere Pro, this is very interesting. RTX 4070 and RTX 4070 Ti both have 12GB of video RAM and they are both very close. So their performance is almost neck to neck. So RTX 4070 Super with 20% more CUDA cores, I would argue it would still be somewhere here. It's not going to beat RTX 4070 Ti because it has less number of CUDA cores. It still has the same video RAM. So your 4070 Super will be somewhere here between these two. So you're not really going to see earth-shattering performance in video editing. It will be better than RTX 4070, but it will underperform 4070 Ti. So in DaVinci Resolve, again, it's the same story. Both 4070 Ti and 4070 are almost neck to neck, and I expect the Super card, RTX 4070 Super, to be here in between these two. So the top dog is still RTX 4090 and 4080, and the AMD card here with the 24GB, I have had mixed luck with this card because on many occasions the Radeon card has crashed when I use DaVinci Resolve. So I'm not very confident about using AMD cards for video editing. My personal experience, I have not been very happy, so I'm not really going to take this guy into account. So what is the bottom line? I think for $600, if you are going to do only pure gaming, then you may have some other choices. You can look at AMD options because the rasterization performance of the AMD cards are comparable. But if you are going to, do ray tracing, and especially if you are going to do AI related work, if you are going to run Stable Diffusion on your PC, do image generation, which is kind of what I have been doing these days. Most of the thumbnails that I make for this YouTube channel, I'm using AI. And this is an area where Nvidia is the king. Nobody can come close to Nvidia. So if you are using an AMD card or an Intel card, good luck with running any AI script. It just does not work. You get lots of crashes and some of the programs outright refuse to run on non-Nvidia hardware. So what do you guys think? Are you guys interested in the Super cards? Do you plan to buy the RTX 4070 Super? Let me know in the comment section below. Now watch this video over here and I will see you guys in that video. Bye.